In today's video, I am going to explain basic anatomy and function of deep lateral rotators. There are six muscles that are considered as deep lateral rotators. Deep lateral rotators of hip. There are six muscles. Let me explain their names and location. First one is this one. This is piriformis. Piriformis that originates from sacrum. Sacrum to here, femur. Particularly this part is greater trochanter. Sacrum to greater trochanter. Okay, this is piriformis. Next two muscles, this one and this one. Their shape looks kind of identical, right? They look like twins. They look like gemini. Thus, this one, the upper one is geminus superior. Geminus superior. And this one, inferior one, is geminus inferior. Geminus inferior. You know, they look like same shape, thus that's geminus superior and inferior. They both from ischium, they both from pelvis, pelvis to here, greater trochanter. Pelvis to greater trochanter. Okay, that's number three, right? One, two, three. Let's go to next one. Next one is this one. This is obturator internus. Obturator internus. Inter means inside, right? This guy is from inside part of pelvis, particularly around obturator membrane. Obturator membrane to greater trochanter. Greater trochanter. Okay, this is internus, so there should be externus. There is obturator externus, but you can't see obturator externus in this picture, so I will show that muscle later on. Okay, this is obturator internus. That is from inside. Okay, last one from this picture. That's this one. Its shape looks rectangular and it attaches to femur. Thus, this is quadratus femoris. Quadratus femoris, that is from ischium right here. And it attaches to a kind of wide region of femur. There is particular name on this area, but since other muscles attached to greater trochanter, I personally remember quadratus femoris also attaches to greater trochanter. Greater trochanter. This is not 100% accurate, but you know it's close enough. It's close enough for greater trochanter. This area is very busy, very dense area. Thus, doing manual therapy around greater trochanter gives huge effect for hip movement and hip stability. Now let's go to front view. Okay, this is anterior view. The last one is this one. This is obturator externus. Obturator externus. We just looked obturator internus. Yes, there is obturator externus. This muscle is also from around obturator foramen, and there is membrane around obturator foramen. That's obturator membrane. Obturator membrane, then it goes to greater trochanter. I mean, this is not 100% accurate. This is just, you know, general area. They all attach around greater trochanter. If you look very detailed anatomy books and anatomy information says slightly different thing, but it's just around greater trochanter. Okay, now let me talk about general function of deep lateral rotators. Alright, what is function of deep lateral rotators? They do lateral rotation, which is external rotation. External rotation of hip. They bring hip this way. It kind of opens up hip this way. This is external rotation. Again, if you look every single detail about these muscles, you see more functions. Like piriformis does hip abduction. Quadratus femoris might do hip adduction. Obturator externus also does adduction. But what all they do is hip external rotation. Okay? External rotation. Plus, important thing is they are important for hip stability. Hip stability, because they are very deep muscles and their size is slightly, you know, smaller than other big muscles such as gluteus maximus and gluteus medius. These six muscles are relatively small compared to other muscles, right? So, as size of muscles gets smaller and smaller and location is deeper and deeper, they are more important for stability. Of course, they are important for mobility, but as equally, stability is important role for small muscles. Does it make sense? So, main function, external rotation of hip and hip stability. Now, let me talk about important anatomical relationship with other tissues. Alright, first thing, there's huge nerve showing up from inferior part of piriformis. What is this big nerve? This is sciatic nerve. Sciatic nerve. In general, this nerve shows up from inferior border of piriformis. If piriformis and other deep lateral rotators get tight, that creates impingement for sciatic nerve. So this impingement creates pain and numbness for sciatic nerve. This is number one, sciatic nerve. By the way, some people's sciatic nerve penetrates piriformis like this. Not 400%, but some people's sciatic nerve kind of penetrates piriformis. In that case, flexibility of piriformis and resiliency of piriformis is even important for this kind of people, right? This literally penetrates piriformis. Thus, tightness of piriformis directly affect for impingement of sciatic nerve. This is important thing. Okay, number one is sciatic nerve. Let's go to next one. Next one is about piriformis again. Piriformis actually originates from anterior surface of sacrum. Okay, it is from anterior part. This is important to know. But what is in front of sacrum? What else? There is internal organs. There is autonomic nervous system. There is lymphatic system. There are arteries and veins. Many things are inside of pelvis. They are anterior from sacrum. So you can say tightness of piriformis may affect for nervous system, internal organ system, lymphatic system, and circulatory system, right? So piriformis is not only for skeletal muscle kind of function, you know, external rotation and stability. This guy is also important for kind of interpelvic balance. This is important muscle. Piriformis and inside pelvic relationship. Next one. Next one I want to focus is two muscles. This is obturator externus and there is obturator internus deep to obturator externus like this. They both attach to obturator membrane. Obturator membrane is like this. So this is like border between outside and inside. Outside and inside. Again, what is inside of pelvis? Internal organs, lymphatic system, autonomic nervous system, many things are inside of pelvis. Obturator internus and obturator externus attach to obturator membrane. What if these two muscles get tight? This tightness may create more tension for inside of pelvis. Then what's going to happen? many balance of internal organs, lymphatic system, nervous system can be aggravated. Thus, obturator muscles are so important. One more thing about obturator externus. Obturator externus is very close to hip ligament, especially pubofemoral ligament. Pubofemoral ligament that connects pubis and femur. The obturator internus and this ligament are very close. If obturator internus gets tight, this tension can create more tension for ligament. What is function of ligament? That stabilizes joint that connects bone to bone. So that may create inhibition for joint movement. This relationship is very important. Okay, so in today's video, I explained basic anatomy and function of deep lateral rotators. And on second part, I explained very important anatomical relationship with these muscles. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.